चित्तवृत्ति निरोधः।
योग चित्तवृत्ति निरोधः। योग इज कंट्रोलिंग, हैविंग ए से ऑन द मॉड्यूलेशंस ऑफ माइंड। यू नो माइंड हैज सेवरल मॉड्यूलेशंस। योगा इज हैविंग ए से ओवर द मॉड्यूलेशन टेंडेंसीज ऑफ द माइंड, हैविंग ए कंट्रोल ओवर द मॉड्यूलेशंस ऑफ द माइंड।
प्रमाण विपर्यय विकल्प निद्रा स्मृतयः।
There are five modulations of the mind in which the mind is lost or the seer is lost. What are the modulations? Pramana. Pramana is the proof. The mind wants proof for everything. Perception with the proof. Perception, understanding of an object with a proof. This is pramana. Then viparyaya. Viparyaya is wrong perception. You have a perception, but that is not the way it is. It is different. And then vikalpa is just imagination. Mental imagination, such things don't exist at all. And then sleep. Sleep is when the mind is sleep is one, and then smriti, memory. These are the five modulation. When we wake up in the waking state of consciousness, we want proof for everything, and we infer proof as three things. One is real experience, then inference, then third is scriptural knowledge.
Pratyakshanumanagamah pramanani.
Let me take pramana one by one. This pramana has three aspects of it. Pramana is a proof. Perception with a proof. So three things. First is direct experience, that is pratyaksha. Then anumana is you guess. There is a smoke, so you guess there is a fire. You are not seeing the fire, but the smoke indicates you that there is fire. And third is by the scriptures. In a bottle it is written poison, you will not say, no, I want to test it. You can't test it. You can't say, no, I want to prove, I want to personally experience it. How can you experience the poison? Right? You cannot, then you won't be there. So this you take it as proof. Now materia medica is there. These herbs are good for this part of the body, or this combination is good for these diseases. All this is written. So this is a proof that we take it. Because for in one's lifetime, you cannot acquire all the knowledge. You can acquire the knowledge which is accumulated over centuries by so many people. And believing in it and accepting it is agama. So scriptural knowledge, scriptural indication. You see in history book, you say, no, I don't believe in the book. I want to see whether really the world war happened or not. How do I know? I don't know. I was not there. So you were not there, but you have to believe a documentation that is available. This is agama. Pratyaksha, anumana, agama. Three type of perceptual understanding or proof. That verifies whether what you know is correct or incorrect.
विपर्ययो मिथ्या ज्ञानमतद्रूप प्रतिष्ठम्।
The second is, that is विपर्यय। विपर्यय is wrong knowledge. You are stuck in your mind from a wrong perception. So your perception is being not right, So you have a wrong understanding. That is viparyaya. Viparyayo mithya jnanam atadrupa pratishtam. You believe what is not and you perceive it that way, wrongly.
Shabda jnananupati vastu shunyo vikalpaha.
And vikalpa is total delusion. Mind is in a delusion, imagination. It's not wrong knowledge, but total imagination.
Abhava pratyaya alambana vrittir nidra.
And then abhava pratyaya alambana vrittir nidra. No one else has ever defined what is sleep in such a beautiful manner, I tell you. When the mind has no content, and in that non-content state of mind gets into a state that is called sleep. Abhava pratyaya avalambana vrittir nidra. That modulation of mind in which it takes recuse into the non-content of the mind, or lack of any content in the mind, amounts to sleep.
Anubhuta vishaya sampramoshaha smritihi.
And then smriti. Smriti is those experiences that your mind could not let go. See, every morning you brush your teeth, but that doesn't remain as a memory. Every day you take breakfast. Do you remember what breakfast you had day before yesterday? 1 week ago? Last month, what breakfast did you have? Can you tell me which cloth you wore on 31st of December or 29th of December, 30th of November? Do you remember? No. Because these are not of any importance. It is neither pleasurable nor painful, so it doesn't make an impact in the consciousness. So some of the experiences that you had, which you have the inability to let go, remains as memory. Anubhuta vishaya asam pramosha. That which you cannot let go remains as memory in your mind. So very pleasant experiences create cravings in you, unpleasant experiences create fear and trauma in the mind. So this is what is memory is all about. So the five vrittis, they're not bad. It's not that they should not be there at all. Usually people say yoga, chitta vritti, nirodha, means all these vrittis should be done with. So there are people who try to keep awake the whole night and not sleep. They're doing wrong. These vrittis are klishta, klishta. Some are difficult, some are not difficult. Some are painful, some are not painful. If you don't get sleep, it is painful. If you sleep too much, it is painful, isn't it? Similarly, if you forget everything, you don't remember anything, it is painful. At the same time, if you cannot forget anything, then also it's painful. You know, similarly, proof can be very painful. And it can be not painful also. Perhaps that's why there is a proverb in English, ignorance is bliss. Ignorance is bliss. You don't know and you are blissful. But when you get the proof, the truth can be hard-hitting. It can be painful. And truth need not be painful also. Both. Similarly, viparyaya, mithyagyan, wrong understanding, is really painful. But again, the same principle, ignorance wrong understanding, you remain in your own little world, and it may be comforting. And vikalpa, imaginations can be pleasurable also. You sit and imagine you have become an angel and flying around in the sky with wings. Yeah, you can have that imagination. It's not painful. And similar, but if you imagine people are all after you and everybody is against you and they are out to get you, it's very painful. So your imagination could be painful or non-painful. So these five vrittis happens, are there anyway. They are indispensable. But if they go out of control, or if they are not in your control, then you can never come back to yourself. So to be back, to understand the seer, to get into the nature of seer, we must have a say over these five modulations of mind.
Let's sit back with a smile, relax, and enjoy the meditation with Gurudev Shri Shri Ravi Shankar.
Let us sit comfortably, easily. First, let us shake our hands. Shake our hands, and then let's keep our hands on our lap, however you feel comfortable. And let's close our eyes. Aankhe band kar le. Reed ki haddi seedha rahe. Let's keep our spine erect and body relaxed. Shareer ko dhila chhod de. We came into this planet weighing just 4 kilos or 5 kilos. Recollect or remember the weight of your body. It is 60 kilos, 70 kilos, whatever that is. Place your weight on the chair or on the floor you are sitting right at this point. Let's take a deep breath in. Hold the breath and let go. Honor your own body. Your body is the precious gift to you from nature. Become aware of your whole body. Skins, tissues, muscles, blood vessels, bones, and all the internal organs. Your body is a precious gift to you. अरबों खरबों अणु परमाणुओं से बना है हमारा अपना शरीर. अपने ही शरीर को मन ही मन आप सम्मान करें. Now let us come to the second dimension, your breath. It is our breath that is keeping our body alive. Your body is alive because of your breath. Take a deep breath in and let go. Incoming breath energizes the body and outgoing breath brings relaxation. This is happening all the time. Let us honor our own breath. अपने ही सांस पर आप गौर करें. आपका सांस भीतर बाहर आ जा रही है. Become aware of the air all around you. Like fish in the water, we are in air. Relax more and more. Let's take your attention to the top of the head. And become aware of the empty space above our head. Become aware of the space in the entire room that you are sitting. हमारा शरीर बाती है तो मन ज्योति है. मन का विस्तार शरीर के चारों ओर है. जो भी विचार आ रहे हो मन में, आने दें. अच्छे बुरे सभी विचारों को स्वागत करें. एक और गहरी सांस लीजिए और छोड़िए. विचारों को गले लगाते जाएं. Embrace all the thoughts, pleasant or unpleasant, good or bad. Become aware of a point right in the center of your heart, center of your chest. And take a deep breath in and breathe out and relax even more. As the body relaxes, the mind expands. And as the mind expands, your body finds deep relaxation. This moment is nothing to do and nothing to know either. Just let go and relax. इस वक्त इस घड़ी में न करने को कुछ है, न जानने के लिए कुछ है. केवल विश्राम करें, अपने आप में विश्राम करें. रिपोज इन योर सेल्फ. You are a fountain of love. You are an ocean of peace. Repose in yourself. मुस्कुराते मुस्कुराते गहरी सांस लीजिए. टेक ए डीप ब्रेथ इन विथ ए स्माइल एंड ब्रीद आउट विथ ए स्माइल. ओम शांति शांति शांति. धीरे धीरे शरीर और परिसर के प्रति सजग हो जाएं. एक और गहरी सांस लीजिए और सांस छोड़ते छोड़ते आप आंखें खोल सकते हो. एज यू ब्रीद आउट यू मे ओपन योर आईज.